It's one of the world's most dangerous sports. But on the Indonesian island of Sumbawa, horse racing runs in the blood. This isn't your average horse race. The jockeys riding bareback and barefoot at incredible speeds are all under 12 years old. Some of them as young as 4.
Kalau sekarang juki itu yang umur 4 tahun atau 5 tahun itu udah enggak bisa.
Nelisa, benar kan? Jadi makin tahun tuh makin kecil.
Once a tradition, horse racing has become a lucrative sport, and the stakes are high for these child jockeys.
Hanya di sekitar sini dia sudah katanya modal kita misalnya nanam padi.
But the cash comes at a cost.
Setelah mendekati tikungan pertama, akhirnya dia jatuh. Kuda yang lain di belakang gerombolan itu misalnya menginjak si awang itu.
Get Real investigates what lies beyond the cash and the glory.
Kalau dia naik, dia dipukul.
And reveals the shocking secrets of Indonesia's child jockeys.
Ini pertaruhan nyawa, like a death race.
Sumbawa Island, southeast Indonesia. Across the island, young boys are preparing for one of the biggest horse races of the year. Eleven-year-old Rezi is a child jockey and trains 3 times a week. He'll be participating in the upcoming race.
Saya naik kuda umur 5 tahun.
Yang umur 2 tahun, 2 tahun setengah, yang baru 2-3 bulan belajar jalan itu udah kasih naik kuda itu. Udah dilatih. Setelah dia udah jalan bagus, bisa jalan bagus, baru dia dikasih naik kuda itu. Umur 2 tahun setengah atau 3 tahun itu.
On this island, horse racing is part of a long-standing tradition. And races have been taking place for as long as anyone can remember.
Sebetulnya permainan anak-anak itu dulu. Pacuan kuda ini permainan hal. Tidak juga di lapangan, tidak juga di mana-mana. Melihat kondisi ini, terbetik keinginan dari orang-orang tuanya kira-kira pada waktu itu seperti itu untuk membentuk suatu kompetisi.
On Sumbawa, custom dictates that jockeys must race bareback and barefoot.
Kalau di situ mungkin udah tradisional kita dari Sumbawa ataupun Bima ini ya. Kalau kita pakai pelana kan, pelana itu kan berat dia. Jadi kuda tidak mampu lari. Jadi kalau yang pakai pelana itu cukup aja kuda di Australia sana. Karena kuda tinggi besar.
In the past, children rode on their family horses, and the winners of a race received token gifts like rice. But modern horse racing resembles nothing from the past. The game has turned into a full-fledged industry. And the grand prizes now come in cash. The upcoming race will have 15 qualifying rounds that will run over 10 days. The winner in each qualifying round will receive a motorcycle, a cow, a refrigerator, and a television. The top 3 grand prizes in the finals range between $300 and $500. In a province where the average income is less than $30 a week, the reward is significant. But nowadays, it isn't jockeys who collect the prize money. It's the horse owners. Muhammad Taufik has registered 3 of his horses in the big race.
Secara finansial di pacuan ya. Di pacuan memang itu merupakan target dari semua peserta. Jelas cari keuntungan dengan harapan kuda mereka keluar akan keluar sebagai seorang juara ya. Kuda mereka itu akan menjadi jadi juara.
So these days, the kids rarely race on their family's ponies. Instead, horse owners pay child jockeys to ride their horses. During the training season, they head to the track to recruit them. And many jockeys now work like freelancers.
Joki itu juga punya kelas kecil kah dia bisa dia tidak bisa tidak dia mengendalikan kuda seperti apa yang kita maukan oleh pemilik kuda.
Pak Taufik has recruited 12-year-old Ayub, who is extremely small for his age and well known on the track for his riding skills. This has made Ayub a popular pick.
Saya dijoki sejak kelas 4 SD. Karena disuruh sama kakek, karena kakek punya kuda, kuda balapan itu.
Terus akhir-akhirnya nah, semua orang pada tahu dia bagus pokoknya si Ayub ini, Mbak. Sekarang pun dia tuh jarang kalau nanti kadang kalau mau pacuan itu 3-4 orang datang, Mbak, katanya.
Horse owners pay the children between $4 to $7 per round in a race, regardless of whether they win or not. On average, jockeys like Ayub will ride up to 10 horses a day and earn $70. At the end of a 10-day competition, they could take home over $700. Ayub is only 12, but he's already one of the oldest jockeys in the circuit. In an anxious bid to win the yearly horse racing competitions, horse owners want jockeys that are younger and smaller.
Joki itu, kalau dulu bisa orang kelas 3, kelas 4 masih jadi joki, sekarang udah ada laku ya. Karena bobotnya sudah naik, udah besar kan. Kuda itu membutuhkan yang bobotnya lebih rendah, lebih kecil kan. Supaya larinya ringan, seolah-olahnya tidak punya orang di atasnya, kan begitu.
Joki itu kategori joki ya, otomatis yang kecil. Kecil dulu, ringan dia, otomatis ringan. Setelah kecil dia ringan, maka enteng dibawa oleh kuda lari.
It's 2 days before the big race, and 7-year-old Egi is out on the track for a practice run.
Ini helm saya, ini Spiderman. Saya suka Spiderman, karena tiap hari nonton.
Pelatihan penunggang kuda, dia umur 3 tahun setengah. Setelah dia menaik kuda, 4 tahun, mulai dia naik kuda.
Egi and his family have come all the way from Bima, a city 12 hours away, to participate in the big race.
Kalau 1 tahun, ada 3 kali, 4 kali, Mbak.
While the jockeys are getting smaller, the race horses are getting bigger and faster. Traditionally, ranches like these raise local Sumbawan ponies for the races. But in the past few years, owners have started importing bigger horses from Europe and Australia to crossbreed them with local ponies.
Unggul, unggul mereka itu punya punya naluri sebagai kuda pacuan itu cukup besar. Lari di pacuan itu handal.
Crossbred horses can gallop up to speeds of 70 kilometers per hour, but with a child's head poised up to 3 meters off the ground, injuries are inevitable. 11-year-old Rezi will be riding one of the star horses in the race, a crossbreed called Bintang Nagari. It will be Rezi's first time racing on a big horse.
Bintang Nagari itu kencang betul, kadang saya takut lari.
But Rezi is willing to take the risk. He earns $7 riding Bintang Nagari. And if he wins, he'll be famous island-wide.
Saya belum pernah menang pacuan kuda. Pacuan kali ini saya ingin menang.
Crossbred horses cost 3 times more on average than Sumbawan ponies. It's a significant investment. And here the horses are treated like star athletes. Subhan Azarullah works for the Samoa Children's Forum, an NGO that campaigns for children's rights on the island.
Orang hanya melihat kuda yang berlari dan menyepelekan si joki ciliknya hanya sebagai penunggang dan hanya yang membuat si kudanya berlari dan membuat si pemilik kuda bangga.
And although jockeys are paid to ride, the practice goes against child labor laws in Indonesia.
But it's illegal in Indonesia to pay children under 15.
Nah, belum pernah ada ya larangan, belum pernah ada larangan, dan itu sudah dari dulu ya.
On Sumbawa, tradition trumps the law. Ayub comes from a family of jockeys and has been riding since he was 9. Despite tradition, his mother wants him to stop.
Karena kami juga enggak ingin anak kami jadi joki, karena joki itu sangat bahaya ya. Semua di mana-mana kalau kita lihat joki lain kan kita kasihan ya, jatuh gini-gini. Tapi akhirnya saya gimana ya? Karena si anak ini enggak mau harus mau. Akhirnya ya karena sudah kebiasaan juga ya. Saya lihat si anak ini teguh gitu, enggak jatuh. Pertama memang jatuh. Pertama tadi waktu jatuh-jatuh saya enggak tegang lihat, Mbak.
The regent of Sumbawa, who heads the local government here, maintains that the races are safe.
Ya, tapi pengalaman selama ini belum pernah ada misalnya meninggal itu patah pun hampir tidak pernah terjadi itu ya.
Dan kebetulan dari sekian tahun semenjak arena pacuan kuda, semenjak pacuan kuda ini menjadi budaya, tradisi kesenian daerah Sumbawa ini, boleh dibilang insiden itu sangat kecil, sangat kecil.
Coba sendiri pengen nggak putranya jadi joki?
Kayaknya enggak.
Kenapa?
Joki ini punya apa ya? Punya semacam mustika mungkin, Pak ya, mustika. Kenal mustika, tahu mustika. Jadi mereka itu jatuh dari sekian insiden yang terjadi itu ya. Kalau kita melihat dari kecepatan sekian puluh meter, kilo 100, mungkin bahkan 100 kilometer per jam ya. Lari jatuh di arena yang seperti ini tidak apa-apa.
But Get Real's investigations found the opposite to be true.
Ada yang patah kaki, ada yang patah tangan. Banyak kalau joki-joki itu tetap setiap hari kalau waktu main itu luka.
Ini pertaruhan nyawa, jadi it's like a death race.
It's 3 days to one of the biggest horse racing events on the Indonesian island of Sumbawa. And young jockeys aged 5 to 12 will be risking their lives to compete for cash and glory. Horse racing is one of the world's most dangerous sports. It has higher fatality rates than motorbike racing and boxing. And unlike the helmets, vests, and boots that are required in the professional leagues, the only safety gear the boys will wear in these small horse racing circuits is a helmet.
Sementara di sini yang dipakai helm hanya helm dari kulit yang dilapisi oleh mungkin spon-spon buatan lokal gitu. Jadi tidak bisa untuk menyerap benturan yang terjadi secara maksimal. Jadi tetap saja hampir seperti benturan tanpa menggunakan helm.
Local officials in Sumbawa say no serious accidents have ever happened at the races.
Baru ada anak-anak yang kecelakaan sampai berbahaya, apalagi meninggal dunia itu tidak hampir tidak pernah. Patah aja hampir jarang ya itu. Belum pernah ada.
Get Real's investigation found the opposite to be true. Sri Fatola's 12-year-old son Ayub became a jockey 2 years ago.
Ya kayak tahun lalu, kayak pacuan gini Mbak ya, latihan. Ada yang dari empang, dia nabrak pagar sama kuda-kudanya, nah mati itu Pak. Kudanya pecah, kepalanya mati kan nabrak pagar ya. Jokinya di ICU meninggal.
Get Real heard accounts of at least 2 race-related fatalities in the past 2 years. In April this year, another boy named Awang fell during a race.
Setelah mendekati tikungan pertama, akhirnya dia jatuh. kuda yang lain di belakang gerombolan itu maksudnya menginjak si Awang itu.
Dari pengakuan keluarga, ketika jatuh sempat pingsan, terus kemudian sadar, dibawa pulang, tidak mau untuk dirawat oleh tim medis. Terus kemudian setelah belum sampai 24 jam di rumah, dia mengalami muntah-muntah, terus penurunan kesadaran, lalu dibawa ke rumah sakit, tapi kondisi sudah terlambat.
According to Dr. Abadi, some of the more serious injuries could have been prevented if the jockeys had gone to a hospital. But many people on Sumbawa cannot afford to pay for medical treatments. 10-year-old twins Sharul and Sharil became jockeys when they were just 4 years old. Last year, Sharul fell from a horse during training.
Tinggi sekali kudanya itu, terus diangkat sama temannya. Sharil, Sharil, bangun nak, bangun nak. Dah terus ambil air pakai botol aqua, siram Sharil supaya bisa ngomong Sharil. Dah bisa ngomong Sharil.
Sharul was rushed to the hospital where he was diagnosed with nerve damage.
Saya tanya dokter berapa biayanya operasi, cuma 1.500.000 gitu. Ibu punya uang nggak? Nggak punya pak dokter. Sampai sekarang nggak belum ada uang.
Because his family didn't have the money, they took Sharul out of hospital and brought him to see a local healer instead. Today, one side of Sharul's body is completely paralyzed.
Dia mau sampai sekarang dia minta naik kuda, bagaimana bisa pegang tali kuda? Sedangkan dia ini enggak bisa goyang apa-apa. Cuci aja enggak bisa dia ini. Makan aja saya harus ditiup.
There's no insurance system for child jockeys in Sumbawa. So who should bear the responsibility when a jockey is injured?
Perda yang mengatur itu misalnya seperti apa tadi misalnya apa cukup asuransi, tapi itu tidak bisa kita putuskan pemerintah. Yang bisa memutuskan itu kan mereka sendiri.
Nah, kita kan cuma menggunakan joki itu 1 tahun. 1 tahun paling lama itu 2 tahun sudah tidak dipakai lagi, sudah pensiun dia, ya kan? Baru ganti joki lain gitu ya. Nah, jadi dalam waktu singkat itu ya kan. Itu aja. Itu tanggung jawab pemilik kuda. Biasanya kan semua hal-hal yang menyangkut itu biasanya yang dilakukan oleh tanggung jawab pemilik kuda. Nah, itu.
Sharul's mother too went to the owner of the horse that her son had been riding at the time of his accident. She wanted him to help with the cost of her son's surgery.
Cuma kasih uangnya sama orang punya kuda itu, anaknya 20.000. Dia, untuk apa uang 20.000 itu?
Despite Sharul's injury, his brother Sharil continues to race. He's become the sole breadwinner in the family.
Setelah ini lagi mungkin pecua saya ini mau ke sana lagi, ke Pandang untuk cari makan sama anak ini. Dia ini tanya, Mama, tidak usah pergi lagi pecoa. Saya ini capek, Ma, di sini, katanya. Ini, istirahat dulu, Mama. Bagaimana, Na, tidak usah istirahat. Kasih ya, kakaknya kuliah di Makassar itu.
Sumbawa is part of one of the poorest provinces in Indonesia. 90% of people work in agriculture. And many are at risk of starvation when their crops fail. So often, parents of child jockeys depend on them to survive. A farmer's annual income in Indonesia is $1,000. Jockeys can earn over 7 times that amount in a year. It's 35 degrees out on the main track. And 12-year-old jockey Ayub has been here for 2 hours. He's on his 4th round of test racing. The big race is just 2 days away, and the number of horses Ayub will ride per day will double. So will his time out in the blistering heat.
Mungkin sih paling banyak 7-10.
Ayub will be able to bring home up to $700 at the end of the 10-day racing event.
Hanya di sekitar sini dia sudah katanya modal kita misalnya nanam padi, beli pupuk bisa dari dia, kata kalau sepatu tas sekolahnya semua biaya sendiri dia.
Dikasih sih sama ayah. Dikasih. Nanti kalau saya mau apa itu dibelikan itu.
Ayub's parents have also been able to use his earnings to save up for his future.
Ya, direncanakan untuk dia, si Ayub ini sudah dikasih walaupun kecil-kecil kambingnya. Kambingnya sekarang udah hamil, kalau ayam-ayam ini kecil ya Mbak ya.
Saya merasa senang karena nggak minta lagi dan nggak ngerepotin orang tua.
Semua orang tua menginginkan anaknya berhasil ya Mbak ya. Ya, anak saya yang besar udah kuliah. Insya Allah si Ayub saya mau suruh kuliah juga, entah dia mau jadi apa. Yang jelas itu sekolah, Mbak.
Ayub's mother has allowed him to continue riding on the condition that he keeps going to school. But many jockeys skip class entirely during the racing season.
Nanti kalau yang sekolah kan izin ke gurunya, satu minggu izin. Ya kan, dikasih izin ya, karena memang kita sama-sama mendukung budaya kan. Ya. Ini kan budaya kita Sumbawa, masa kita mau persoalan joki, ya kan?
But with up to 10 racing events that last 10 days each every year, jockeys may miss over 100 days of school.
Dan ini juga menjadi hal yang cukup berat juga, karena dari segi orang tuanya juga yang menekankan kepada mereka ya, untuk apa sih nanti belajar, tapi akhirnya kamu juga menjadi joki cilik. Jadi,
cuman pesan orang tuanya, kamu anak, enggak apa-apa ikut joki. Ya, supaya ada uang sehari-harimu.
Being a jockey is a short-term career. Once children get too heavy or too old, they're out of the race. But while they're still able, they can earn 5 times more than the average annual income in the province. And it's this system of payment that is opening up the way to abuse.
Yang sering dihanu sama bapaknya. Kalau udah naik, dia dipukul.
On the Indonesian island of Sumbawa, what was once a sport has turned into a major money-making venture. In just a day, 400 horses and 70 child jockeys will be competing in one of the biggest horse racing events of the year. Child jockeys here earn money for each round during both practice runs and the race, regardless of whether they win. And many families have become dependent on this income. Brothers 17-year-old Ayen and 10-year-old Ferry are both jockeys.
Saya tetap juara baru-baru jadi joki. Saya rasain dapat motor, semua gembira orang. Kamu harus terus jadi joki, katanya orang, penonton-penonton. Saya harus berusaha.
Ayen started racing when he was 12 to support his family. Over the years, Ayen saved up enough money to buy a small house and some cattle for his mother and brothers. But when he turned 15, his life changed. Today, everything this young champion worked for is gone.
Tapi karena sekarang ini bapaknya udah keluar dari penjara, lihat anaknya dapat rumah mewah, sapi banyak. Akhirnya bapaknya itu tahu main perempuan itu habis punya dia semua. Kasihan anaknya itu.
Ayen and Ferry's mother remarried and moved to work as a cleaner in Abu Dhabi. They moved in with their father, who lives and works for the owner of a ranch. The boys now sleep in a stable.
Cuman anaknya rata-rata mereka, Din itu hasil anaknya dia, sehari-hari itu dari hasil anaknya ya. Dia tanpa kerjaan, bahkan sebenarnya dia yang urus kuda ya. Tapi dia katanya seperti bos, anaknya jadi anak buahnya dia. Dianya nggak kerja, si anak yang disuruh kerja.
Ayen and Ferry's father, Pak Din, also sends them to the track to test ride horses as often as possible. Owners pay jockeys to get their horses accustomed to the circuit before a race. The brothers can earn $4 each per round. Ian's best friend, 11-year-old Rezi, witnesses the abuse daily.
Ian sering dihanu sama bapaknya, disuruh kasih mandi kuda, disuruh ambil rumput, disuruh naik kuda. Kalau tak naik, dia dipukul. Uangnya itu diambil sama bapaknya, semua diambil. Karena saya kasihan, sering ngobrol sama Ian.
Ian's father would not allow Get Real to interview Ian in private.
Sekarang masih ada semua atau?
Saya nggak tahu saya di mana tempatnya.
Pak Din, untuk sendiri, Pak Din udah nabung tuh untuk apa untuk masa depannya?
Nah, udah punya sapi, gitu ya. Tabungannya untuk masa depannya diantar waktu udah besar. Gitu. Nah, kalau orang tuanya.
Get Real asked to see the livestock that Pak Din had bought for his sons, but were told that they were in a farm far away. The brothers will be taking part in the upcoming competition. But at 17, this will be Ian's final race. He is close to the end of his jockey career. Most jockeys have never experienced a life outside of racing.
Jadi mereka sampai SMA bersekolah seperti biasa dan habis itu mereka kalau untuk memikirkan untuk kuliah sih tidak, lebih lagi ternyata mereka karena berasal dari keluarga petani, jadi mereka kembali lagi ke petani dan menjalin membentuk sebuah rumah tangga dan sebagainya macamnya. Jadi lebih ke mereka bertani.
Others end up going back to the world they know best.
Pengen mengurus kuda, pilih kuda yang banyak. Biar jadi bos. Saya sama Perry ini. Nanti Perry jadi bos kuda, nanti saya jadi rawatnya. Itu katanya saya dari kecil sama Perry. Perawat kuda yang paling setia sama kuda.
Once Ian retires, his younger brother Ferry will take over as the main breadwinner.
Dan kebetulan juga kan dia itu berhasil juga. Jadi joki bisa dia semua mengumpulkan. Enggak sih, bukannya ini, enggak sih kita paksa dia untuk dia harus menjadi joki. Enggak sih. Cuman ya dia keinginannya dia sendiri.
It's the evening before the race, and horsekeeper Kurais is prepping prized horse Bintang Nagari. His 11-year-old brother Rezi will be riding him in the competition.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
As part of tradition, each horse and jockey is blessed by a shaman. Belief in magic runs strong on Sumbawa. Child jockeys are made to believe, with the blessing of the shaman, they are superhuman.
Kencang larinya nanti.
It will be 12-year-old Ayub's second race in his career. He's a hot favorite on the track.
Gak takut sih, karena saya sudah berani gitu nih. Gak takut sih, jatuh. Karena sudah ada yang pakai jimat gitu. Gak takut sih. Kalau mungkin rezeki saya bisa menang.
It's day one of one of the biggest racing events on Sumbawa Island. Close to 400 horses and 70 jockeys will be competing over the next 10 days. And families from across the island have traveled here with their horses and kids in tow. All in the hopes that their children will bring honor and income to the household. The first race of the day is about to begin, and 7-year-old Eggy is heading into the starting gate. The starting gate is the most dangerous part in a race. Assistants are tasked with leading the horses into a tight, confined space. while the jockeys balance the barrier ready to hop on. Some horses refuse to enter. Others panic once they're inside and could potentially crush the heads of children sitting on top of them. Eggy is racing at speeds of up to 80 kilometers per hour. It's less than 120 seconds to the finish line. On standby are paramedics, but they're vastly outnumbered by shamans. And one of these healers tends to the jockey's injuries instead. Shamans are considered by many to be the real doctors of Sumbawa, curing with magic rather than medicine.
Cuman adat di sini itu bahwa perkataan seorang dokter itu kalah oleh perkataan sang shaman atau sang sandro dalam bahasa Sumbawanya. Pasien datang hanya minta rongsen, kemudian membawa sang dukun, nanti ditanya ke dukunnya, dukun bisa enggak untuk menangani ini? Ketika dibilang bisa, sudah, mereka pulang. Dan dari kasus yang saya temui, semua bilang, dukunnya bilang bisa menangani.
A shaman's diagnosis is rarely questioned, and it can become a life sentence. In April 2015, a young jockey named Awan died after he fell on the racetrack. His family refused to bring him to the hospital and took him to a shaman instead.
Jadi mereka lebih menuruti kata shamannya untuk membawa pulang karena dibilang oh tidak apa-apa.
2 days later, Awan was dead.
Di depan. Iya. Masih Superman memimpin di depan.
Eggy has won his first race. And is carried right back to the starting gate for round two. He gets paid up to $7 per race, whether he wins or loses. But the money he makes is nothing compared to the cash changing hands around the racetrack. Although gambling is illegal in Indonesia, Get Real spotted at least two bookies taking bets around the track.
Ya kalau di atas panggung itu kan panggung besar itu penuh orang judi. Jadi kalau satu hari itu mereka itu kalau kita lihat-lihat pegang uang itu ada yang ratusan. Sampai berpuluh-puluhan. Iya. Sampai ratusan juta kalau mereka itu adu pecahan kuda itu mereka tanding uang di atas yang judi itu ada yang 10 juta ada yang 20 juta ada yang 100 200 juta satu kali lari.
But the money exchanging hands on the tribune is nothing compared to what horse owners stand to make if they win.
Kalau Bima itu makanya berani bayar mahal-mahal juki ataupun apa itu. Dia dapat nama dan juga kudanya nanti mahal-mahal harganya dijual semua. Kalau yang udah dapat bendera satu kali itu, yang dapat bendera satu kali itu minimal harganya itu sampai 300-400 juta.
And with that much money at stake, it's become about winning at all costs, including sabotage. Twelve-year-old jockey Ayub is about to compete in one of the biggest horse racing competitions on the Indonesian island of Sumbawa. Ayub comes from a family of jockeys, And for him, racing is about honor and pride. Most of the money he earns goes into his savings. A horse is missing a rider, and 17-year-old Ayan is called in to take his place. For Ayan, the stakes in the race are different from Ayub's. He's close to retirement, and every last $7 he can earn per round is precious. If his father lets him keep the money. Because Ayan has been hired to ride last minute, there's no time to find an extra helmet. His father lets him ride off without one. For horse owners, winning means the value of the amounts could shoot up into tens of thousands of dollars. With stakes that high, some resort to dirty tricks.
Saya merasa takut karena nanti kaki saya terkena sama besi box tali itu.
Ah, itu kadang bayaran itu, Mbak. Kalau joki-joki yang sudah anu itu, Mbak, bahaya itu. Bayar kuda ini kamu ginikan, senggol temannya atau ada aja caranya.
Ayub has come in second, and veteran rider Ayan third. It's close to the end of the first race day. 7-year-old Eggy has been racing under the hot sun for nearly 4 hours. The heat is starting to take a toll on him. Both Ayan and his brother survived the first day of the races unhurt. But other children have had close calls. The conditions on the circuit, a lack of safety gear, and illicit gambling have raised concerns in the past. In 2010, the chief police officer in charge of safety and security at the races threatened to cancel the event.
Alasannya boleh diberikan izin, namun kami harus memakai pelana, memakai helm, pakai sepatu safety, dan umur jokinya 17 tahun sampai 15 tahun. Jadi mungkin ada hal-hal di luar konteks kami. Saat itu Pak Kapolres bilang ke kami ini melanggar perlindungan anak. Nah, kami ini tidak memikir seperti itu. Karena kami sebagai pewaris budaya ini.
Despite protests from horse owners and race organizers, the event was shut down.
Ya, karena ada benturan-benturan sedikit, sehingga kami saat itu kami melaporkan ke Pak Bupati bahwa tidak diberikan izin oleh Pak Kapolres.
A meeting was held with the district committee and the sports associations involved in the races. A few days later, the police officer who banned the event was transferred to a different district, and the races continued.
Kita akhirnya sepakat gitulah. Nah, semuanya kita jaga bersama, budayanya kita kembangkan, ya alhamdulillah sampai hari ini. Ya kan? Tidak ada persoalan baik itu pelanggan HAM, persoalan apa, memang fokus kita bahwa inilah tradisi budaya yang unik, ya kan?
Some believe there was pressure from powerful horse owners to allow the racing to continue.
Yang memiliki kuda-kuda tersebut berasal dari kalangan-kalangan yang bisa dikatakan orang-orang yang cukup punya nama besar seperti itu di Sumbawa. Sehingga ada pemerintah kah di dalam itu yang mendukung itu, saya rasa ada. Karena orang-orang yang ada di pemilik kuda juga berasal dari orang-orang tersebut seperti itu.
Get Real investigated this claim and obtained a list of owners who had registered their horses in this year's race. At least 6 names were connected to positions in the provincial government, in the national government, in the military, and in state-owned enterprises. Get Real also learned that the following officials in Sumbawa own horses. Haji Mustami Haji Hamza, chairman of the National Sports Committee of Indonesia, which manages the races, and who is also in charge of the Equestrian and Horse Racing Association of Sumbawa, the body that processes the permits for the races, as well as Jamaluddin Malik, the regent of Sumbawa.
Adanya keterlibatan pemerintah sebagai pendukung dari beredaran joki cilik itu tidak bisa terlepas, sehingga pemerintah justru membuat event-event, misalnya event ada festival pecuan kuda tetap ada, sehingga melahirkan joki ciliknya tetap ada di dalamnya. Dan secara tidak langsung bentuk joki cilik inilah yang mengasah perlakuan atau tradisi joki ciliknya sendiri atau pecuan kudanya sendiri ini yang melakukan seolah-olah menjadikan tindak kekerasan terhadap anak itu sendiri.
Day 2 of the race. Eggy is heading back to the starting gate. He's won 4 out of 9 races, and this will be his final round. The center horse suddenly veers right out of the starting gate and pushes Eggy's horse into the wooden barrier. A paramedic on standby attends to Eggy's wounds. But before he can check for any internal injuries, the family shaman whisks him away. Back at the tent, the shaman is applying traditional methods to heal him.
Kalau untuk sementara hasil terawangan kita baru luka luar, baru goresan, tidak terlalu parah. Lukanya tidak terlalu parah, ya cukup diobati secara hati-hati dan manual saja. Tapi insya Allah besok bisa naik lagi.
Get Real offered to bring Eggy to the hospital, but the family refused.
Tapi cukup obat itu kuat landasi ke rumah sakit dokter. Memang anaknya lain ini, kan keturunan juki semua nih dari kakak bapaknya. Dari turun temurun ya, kelanjutannya gitu.
The next day, Eggy is back on the track again.
Keluar dari monster terus tabrak pagar. Hari ini saya ikut pacuan lagi.
He's lucky to have gotten away with just a leg injury, but there are still more days of racing left. And this cycle will continue year after year until Eggy is either too old or too heavy to ride. It's minutes before star horse Bintang Nagari is due to run the race that will determine if he qualifies for the finals. Bintang's trainer Kurais is suddenly nervous about his chances.
Ya, musuhnya dia sekarang ini itu senior semua. Jadi dia ini kan baru naik kelas di kelas ini. Jadi dia ini sangat kasihan sama kita karena musuhnya dia itu berat-berat, semua itu senior, dia ini kan junior dia. Jadi kita dah takutnya dia nanti, biar laju tapi teman-temannya itu senior semua.
Kurai's younger brother Rezi was supposed to ride Bintang Nagari in the race, but he's been swapped for a smaller, lighter rider called Shaiful. It's just the way things are on the racing circuit. Bintang Nagari wins the race by close to 3 horse lengths. The racehorse's value has just shot up by over $40,000. The prize for Kurais and young jockey Shaiful, pride and glory.
Senang banget ini, udah nomor satu dia nih. Dia udah bisa kalahkan kuda yang juara selama ini.
Ayub ended up winning three races. He remains a track favorite. At the end of the week, Egi will return home. His family have already registered him for an upcoming race in another district. Days after Get Real finished filming, Ian fell during a race and injured his back. His father refused to take him to a hospital. Officials say that child jockeys like Ian, Egi and Ayub are part of a tradition that must be preserved. But there is another motivation to keep the races going.
Nah, ke depan dengan perkembangan yang terjadi, pacuan kuda ini kita harapkan bisa menjadi salah satu destinasi yang bisa mancing orang, memikat orang dari luar, wisatawan baik nasional maupun mancanegara.
The regional government has big plans for the sport in the future. And with that, the races and the child jockeys are unlikely to disappear.